Hello, I'm Monica Price and welcome to Cuppa TV. Today's show sees my sofa full of men, but not just any men, very talented and skilled performers. Regarded as one of the best male variety shows in London, we welcome Forbidden Nights. And then we have a group of young men who are exploding on the music scene and are tipped to be the breakthrough act of 2015, the five-piece band that make Franklin Lake. Perform their shows to sell out audiences in London, and you may have already seen them on Britain's Got Talent. We welcome the very talented Forbidden Nights. Guys, welcome to Cuppa TV!
Thank you so much. That's all right, so lovely.
So we've got, who have we got?
Ozzy on the fire act.
Hello, Ozzy.
I'm Lewis, I'm the singer.
Fantastic.
I'm Billy, and I'm the aerialist.
Fantastic. So, guys, I mean, you class yourselves as a male variety show. Yeah. So, how did that all begin? Where did you start?
It was a bit of a long story. Basically, Billy
We've
and I.
We've got time. Billy We've and got I coffee. Were, it's fine.
Billy and I were in a separate show with another member of the group that's not here right now, Ollie.
Say hi to Joe.
But the three of us were in a separate show, and we just saw a gap in the market. Mm. We realised that there'd been lots of shows that had not really changed for a really long time, and we saw that there was no male variety was not a thing.
No, because there's male strippers.
Yeah.
You know, but there isn't.
And variety shows.
Yeah, and variety shows. So presumably, did you decide to kind of put those two together?
Yeah, like these sort of strip show genre hasn't changed for ages, and we decided that the three of us all had a talent.
Yeah.
So why not add two more talented lads and just make everyone in the show has to bring something to the table rather than just lads taking their top off.
Especially for like birthdays, hen-dos, like everything, and like we said, the entertainment 10, 15 years has been the same thing, and we were like, well, women want more.
Yes.
You know, they can see it on the TV, they can see it, you know, so we basically just fused, you know, all the key attributes of the variety acts, some full production that we built. So we have like a raining stage, which is 100 litres of water a minute, Ollie, or like that.
Wow.
And we designed it, built it, flooded my dad's unit three times trying to make but our finale is a water curtain that we produce, which is incredible. So we're very much hands-on. We set the stage.
It sounds like you're very hands-on with it all. You get everything ready.
In the show, Billy and I have built ourselves.
Wow. So for those of you who don't know anything about you, so Ozzy, just what do you do? What do you do in the show?
I'm fire act, so I spin fire. Drop things every now and again.
Yeah.
A bit of fun, really.
Right, and you're obviously not from this country?
No, Australia.
You're from Australia, I recognise that accent.
Australian.
So, were you working in the UK before, or did you come over to do this?
No, I came over just on a visa, just like every other Aussie. It's like I was planning on working in a bar to see where it went, travel a bit. Mm. And
this is a bit different.
Yeah. I was down in Cornwall, and a friend of mine said, look, if you want to try modelling. So I thought, you know what? I go to London and give it a crack, and they said, "But if you're going to make something of yourself, go to London." So I jumped online. I wanted to get into sort of like the top waitering, hosting sort of thing, and I found these guys and sent them an email. And I said, "Yeah, mate, come in. We'll take a look at you." Mm. I think from there it was like originally there was no spot for me. I said, "Look, I really just want to be a part of it. There's something amazing you have here."
We had a full cast at the time.
Really?
Because
how many's in your cast, really?
There's five.
Five.
Main acts.
Yeah.
Then we've also got Lewis. We've got five main acts performers, and we've got Lewis Wynyard, who is our sort of West End compere, comedian compere.
Yes.
So he fuses the whole thing together. And then we've got three dance crew, so that brings a dancing element into
so
it as well.
So it's a real mixture. So you're the firefighter. And, so Lewis, now I recognise you because you were the first one that came out on the stage, weren't you, for Britain's Got Talent, that audition.
Yeah.
So you're the singer.
I am the singer.
So again, how long have you been doing, you know, your singing?
Like forever. I think I started singing when I was six. Like I'd done like the whole range of singing. Like when I was 6 to 11, like I was a proper chorus boy. Like in one of the, you know, the like choir.
Yes.
That was me. And like,
is he like that now?
Yeah.
And I was lucky enough to sort of, I toured Europe and stuff with choirs and stuff, being like the altar boy, like lead little killer.
That was me.
And then just never really stopped singing throughout school. Then I studied singing, and then I don't really know how I ended up here, but I couldn't be happier. Like it was a really long process.
Yes.
I was signed as a songwriter, and then did musical theatre, and then ended up creating this show with Billy. It's been a bit of a weird thing, but it couldn't have gone better.
And Billy, over to you. Tell us what you do. What your role is.
Yeah, Billy, what do
they
you
laugh.
Do?
They laugh what when we say
do?
That, Billy.
That's well,
is that a good sign?
I do aerial. So basically...
Yeah, what does that mean?
Exactly. What does
do
that mean?
Do you skydive over?
It's just
what
vague,
does that mean?
So then no one ever asks.
It's vague. And because of rigging specification, it means I don't have to do a lot of my solo. So I do aerial chains and aerial silks. Chains is a routine that's meant to
So change, you're up,
yeah.
you know,
yeah, just suspended.
Suspended, and I've seen that, and they come down on the silks.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
what you do.
That's what I do. However, we don't have all the rigging points in all the venues.
Right.
So I'm the one that doesn't have to do, if it's solo yeah, drop,
Is that his excuse?
Yeah. Basically, yeah. So it's been a long-running joke, but I doubt need to...
So, I mean, when you first came together and you said, you know, when you were in a previous show and, you know, what were you thinking? Were you thinking, right, we've just got to put these two elements together? How did it all come about?
Everything, really, yeah. wasn't it? It was, I mean, we like business. Obviously, it is fundamentally
Absolutely,
a business.
Absolutely, yes.
We saw that there's a market there and we thought we just wanted to produce something that's never been produced before. And... We just literally brainstormed and said, right, well, if we just have production and take these infuses elements, it looked great.
It
was people they really
it was
liked
a risk
it.
From our point of view because yeah. there wasn't anything, so it could, like...
Yeah, when we started, we were like, is that Mel Shropshire? We were like, well, no.
And that was, like, oh, it was really it, difficult like, when we
well,
started.
No, how long did it take? I mean, male
variety was not
really
a thing, so no. you could put that in any...
Google it again, what are you talking about?
Are you the only one of your kind in the UK, do you know, that are performing like this?
We are the only one in the world, I would say, that do what we do.
Well,
it's actually
yeah,
true. Like, obviously,
amazing.
There are major companies like Chippendales and stuff,
yes.
but they don't
that
do...
A strip show, if that makes sense.
They don't do
aerial.
They don't.
I haven't seen them do aerial.
They don't do the fire.
or fire.
I think they've done something.
I think they've done a fire, but never. There's no one that does everything, and that is true. Like, we've researched it, because we're like, surely we can't be doing
it.
Yes.
It's so obvious.
But sometimes it's the obvious things, though, that you know that you put it together and think, oh, why hasn't anybody else thought about this before? But then, good job they haven't, obviously.
Yeah, we said the other day that male variety is, like... the male variety show. I was like, I think we made that up. Like, there was nothing before, and now competitors are like saying...
We've had a few people now gone, oh, we're at a male variety show. We're like, oh, hold on a second.
Like, other people have been like, oh, yeah.
But I mean, Ozzy, what's it like, you know, for you? Presumably you love what you do with the guys. I mean, is it a quite tight crew that you've got?
Well,
it seems to be...
Forbidden Family, like hashtag Forbidden Family.
Yes.
That is, and we are, aren't we?
We do everything together.
Yeah.
Basically. Especially down in London. We have... the compere, we mainly all base ourselves at his house around the weekend when the show's on.
The dream is to have a forbidden house one day.
Yeah.
We live, breathe, sleep. Yeah. Everyone mucks in for everything. If anyone's like poorly, the other one looks after them. If anyone needs something sorted, they get it done.
Yeah.
I've never, from the show perspective, they work so hard. Like, the chairs get put out, the stage gets put up.
So it really is
hands on. We don't have anyone work for us that's not in the show. Like,
there's
no
edge of braces. So like, roller suits that we get.
Everyone has. We have to build the stage ourselves.
And
so
do it all yourself before you start.
And the dancers and build the stage and rigging every week, every show.
So you perform every week in London at the moment.
At the Clapham Grand.
At the Clapham Grand.
Which actually has got a great story. It was originally a theatre.
Now
it's a nightclub. So we have beautiful cascading balconies, we've got
wonderful.
Full stage, and we've got the nightclub for the after party.
So, and you're also doing the Magic Mike, aren't you?
Well,
tell me
Magic
about
Mike,
that.
Magic Mike XXL is coming
Magic
out.
Magic Mike XXL,
it's a huge, it's Channing Tatum's new film, which sort of covers this sort of element of the scene, as it were.
We were lucky enough to work on the premiere of the first one, which is a huge... Like,
yeah,
honor.
We met Channing Tatum, which was cool.
Great.
Yeah, we did.
And I think that has helped with their show. They really put production into, like, it's a film, so it's like a glamorized version of the stripping.
And Channing can dance.
Yeah.
So how do you see your future then, guys? How do you see the future of Forbidden Nights? What would you like to do?
Australia, Vegas.
Yes, we've got it all here.
Yeah, so tour in Australia.
So you'd like to go global?
Well, I think hopefully January, possibly a tour.
We are looking to try and do a month or in January. So we're looking to do a tour in January.
Fantastic.
Really exciting.
So in the business way, I'm the idealist and he's the realist. So it works really well.
That works really well.
I'm adamant that we're going to have a Vegas show in the next 5 years.
Yeah.
That would be amazing.
Go bankrupt, is pretty much
well, if you do. Well, if you're in Vegas, I hope I get front seat coming on to Cuppa TV. Absolutely. Well, guys, it's been great, but you know we've got to go to break now. But before we go to break, thank you for you guys for coming.
That's
really
nice.
Pleasure
so
to
much.
Meet you. But we're going to have a look at the teaser of your show. So come back and join me in just a minute. Will you walk the line like it's still a chance? Just forget the wins, it's the place to use. Cuppa TV. It's all about the guys today, as my next guests to join me are a young band who are making waves in the music scene, working with some of the top producers and determined to be the band of 2015. Let's welcome Franklin Lake. Hello!
Hi.
Guys,
hi.
Welcome to Cuppa TV.
That was a beautiful introduction.
Oh, what can I say?
How you do that?
I write it myself. Guys, it's so lovely to see you. So who have we got? Let's start.
I'm Tom.
Tom.
My name's Carl.
I'm Ed.
I'm Jude.
Jude.
And I'm Tay.
Wonderful. Excellent. And guys, may I say, you look very, very smart today.
Thank you.
Nice to see you dress up for Cuppa TV. So guys, how did it all begin then? Because you are a young boy band, but where did it all start? Did any of you know each other? How did it all begin?
It all began, I'd say, about a year ago. But I mean, before that, me, Jude and Tay, this one here, yep. He was in a band before as a three, kind of just doing the same thing, gigging. And we thought, you know, we want to make it a bit better. So yeah. Our manager, we thought, auditioned a couple of people, and these two
got a very lovely.
Yes, that's it. Yeah.
A year on, and it's just going great.
Fantastic. Yeah, and so how old are you? I call you a young band. You have to give me your exact age.
I've got a beard, but I'm not 30.
So you're young guys looking forward to a bright future.
Definitely.
Yeah. Exactly. So you three knew each other.
Yeah.
So you auditioned and then you got together. So how did that feel?
Around the same sort of time.
Yeah.
Within a week apart, wasn't it?
Really?
Yeah. I was a week after Ed, and then we were in. It was a five, and from then on it's just been
fantastic.
Crazy.
Yeah. So guys, you've been doing so much. I mean, what happened? Tell us. How did it all begin? So you all got together. Yeah. Then what?
You know, we all got together, and I think the main objective, it was just the hit studio release. Mm. We've never been a fan of kind of just putting out covers. We've always wanted to put out our own stuff.
Yeah,
original music.
It was first kind of started off as studio a lot,
yes.
Like every night. And then it was the case of kind of getting it out there. So gigging in all these different cities. And now we've actually got an EP that's available to pre-order.
You've got your new EP debut single, isn't it? That's called Supersonic.
Yeah,
you're actually going to play. We're going to play that to our viewers at the end. The end of the show. Yeah. But you know, was it something when you all got together? You know, you seem to have gelled really quickly. Because how long ago was this? Was this just a few years ago?
I think it was just under a year, so about 8 months ago.
Yeah, and we've all just bonded really.
Yeah.
Is that really important?
Yeah, 100%. We've all got different personalities.
If we didn't have the bond we did, I don't think any of this would be how it is now.
And I love your look. Who determined your look? Was that something?
I'd like to say myself.
Yes, you
but it's not really. It was a mixture of everyone.
But then you'd be lying.
Exactly, and I'm not a liar. It's we've got a great team behind us as well, and we all kind of put thoughts into it. So
So how do you describe your music?
It's difficult. I think we've got a very original sound out there that we can't really. There's no one really compare to.
I think we've got an R&B pop R&B. Sound with an 80s twist to it as well.
We've been introduced like an urban pop.
Got a bit of rap in there as well.
I've heard urban pop a lot, but it's good because if you listen to the first song on the EP and then listen to like the fifth song, they're completely different. Yeah. It does go from like a dance pop to a kind of like.
And is that what you want, guys? Is that what you're looking for?
Yeah, definitely. Like, we want to make ourselves stand out from the industry and to all other acts. Like, we respect all other acts, definitely, but we just want to stand out and be like the biggest artists of our generation.
Yeah.
Because there are other boy bands out there. So what makes your boy band different to any other?
We're a mixed ethnicity group, so we all come from different backgrounds. Yes. Mixed ethnicity.
Yes.
And us being in the studio working together, like writing different music, writing different songs, like we all put our own little bits to it and different ideas, and yeah, we've all got different personalities.
So you all do the writing?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So you all sort of contribute to the song. So tell us about Supersonic then. How did that start? Oh, it's going to take a breath.
Yeah,
it's his favourite song.
Oh, is it your favourite song? Well, tell us about it.
We had the track from our producer.
Yeah.
Well, it's a very 80s sort of feel. And we thought it was going to be very different to the stuff we've been doing. And once we got it down, we just thought this is going to be wicked. So.
And you've worked with some top producers. In fact, you're still working with some top producers, aren't you? You know, you've been very lucky. I mean, that you've worked with the Soul Shaker, Dasko, you know, Mob Culture. You know, you're really working with some of the top people in the industry. Is that important to you as well?
Yeah, and Soul Shaker was great. They've actually put like a really great remix onto Supersonic. So, we hope it's going to be.
So I hope it's going to be. And when you were putting it together, did it feel right? Were you happy with it?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it was like a mutual decision that we thought Supersonic would be the track that we would go with, and it grows on you. It really does.
You've got to move to it.
Literally, like, just to say as well, when we go like to different areas, maybe some people that don't even know who we are yet, and as soon as they see us come on stage and we start performing Supersonic, you just see everyone just clapping along and even dancing along, and they'll end up catching on with the lyrics as well.
It's a great film.
And you've got a big fan base growing, haven't you? Which is great. Definitely. Well, before we hear Supersonic, I'd like to hear a little live rendition of something. Will you do that for me? Getting ready. Prepare yourself. That's great. So what are you going to do? What are you going to sing?
We'll sing one of our songs, Survivor. It's one of our own original songs that
Fantastic.
We've all had a part of.
Brilliant.
It's a very big song to us. It's one of our like songs that represent
us. Trademark song.
It's our trademark song.
Over to you then, guys.
Yeah, should it?
Okay. Yep.
Get ready.
Right.
A cappella version.
Of course.
Go for it.
One. Drive by in front of me. Couldn't believe my eyes. How could I erase the memory? Fighting over pride. Out on the front line. We're gonna be saving lives. You have power over me. You need to know that it's my life. You're the one thing on my mind when I'm on the front line. Closing my eyes and knowing I've tried to escape this memory. It only matters when I hear you.
When I hear you.
It only matters when you speak.
When you speak.
It only matters when I'm near you.
I'm near you.
The barrier's up, but I can't breathe.
I can't breathe.
Survivor.
That's fantastic, that's just great. And well, guys, unfortunately we've nearly run out of time, so but you know, it's just been fantastic. Make sure you come back and join us, and you know, absolutely come back for my cushions. It's lovely, comfy sofa. It sounds good to me.
I just like the dress that you're wearing.
Thank you so much. You can come back anytime. Thank you so much. Well, guys, it's been a pleasure to meet you. Thank you. So that's it for today. I'd like to thank all my guests for joining me, and thank you for watching. We'd love to hear from you, so please do get in touch either by email or join us on Facebook or Twitter at Big Centre TV. And now to play us out, let's enjoy Supersonic by Franklin Lake. Bye bye.